Hey everybody, what is going on? This is Orby3NWO bringing you my top 5 under the radar fullbacks for Madden 13. These aren't the best fullbacks in Madden, but these are some guys that you can use in your superstar mode or your coach mode if you want to save some cap space, or if you just want to use somebody that's not already at the top of the food chain. These are also some guys you can use against your friends who may not have heard of them and make you look like a real Madden genius. So let's jump right into the list. Number 5 is the Giants' Henry Hynoski. Now this guy is one of your prototypical fullbacks. He's not very fast. He's not real tall. He's a very strong, powerful runner, though. Let me go over some of his stats with you. Again, like I said, his speed is only a 69. His acceleration is a 75, which is actually pretty decent to go along with 63 agility. But if you look at his strength, it is an 84, which is the second highest on this list. His trucking is also a 74. Again, I said he's a very strong runner. His ball carrier vision is only a 52, which doesn't matter so much if you're controlling him. What is a little odd is that his catching is actually higher than his carrying. It's 72 to a 68, which means that you feel free to get him out there and throw the ball to him. Screens, you know, some little short passes out into the flats. He can handle all of that. He has good catching traffic. Out of all of his moves, stiff arm, spin move, and juke, his spin and juke are pretty low, 55 and 60, but his stiff arm is an 80, which is the highest out of any move on this list. He's a slightly better run blocker than pass blocker, and he has a 74 impact block. Overall with this guy, I would say get the ball in his hands through passes, let him do a little work, hit some people with a stiff arm, and throw him to the ground. Number 4 is the 49ers' Bruce Miller. This guy gets a little more to my type of player in Madden. He's a little faster than most of the other guys. His speed is a 75, which is the second highest on this list. He's got 82 acceleration and a 72 agility rating to go along with a 77 strength, so he's not weak by any means. His trucking is just a 66, but if you look into some of his other stats, he makes up for it a little bit. He's a little more of a blocker than someone that you'd want to get out on every single play and run to. His catching is a 69 and his carrying is a 69. He's slightly better run blocker than pass blocker. He's got solid moves all the way across, a 70 stiff arm, which is very good, 50 spin. His impact blocking is an 87, which is very high. That's the highest on this list except for one other player. So like I was saying, he's going to work better as a normal style fullback, but he does have the moves and the hands to break out and make some plays for you when you need. The things that I like to do with Bruce Miller is kind of misdirection and deception. When you're at 3rd and 2 and they're expecting, you know, a run up the gut, you can maybe put him out in the flats or run a screen. Or if you're 4th and 1 and they're, you know, anything that you want to do to kind of deceive the other team, this guy will work very well with. You can get him in and he will get the yardage for you. Number 3 is Mike Cox from the Atlanta Falcons. This is another guy that's very strong. This is the strongest guy on our list. He has 70 speed, 72 acceleration, and 64 agility. But his strength is an 85, which again is very high for any different position on this game. His trucking is a 68. His catching and carrying, this guy is the one that goes a little to the opposite that some we've seen so far. His catching is a 60 and his carry is a 68. His run block, again, just like just about everyone else on this list, is higher than his pass blocking. He's got good moves as well. His moves are not quite as good as the other two we've seen so far, though. He does have a good stiff arm at 70 to go along with an 82 impact block, which is very high. This is a guy that you can really run any way you want to, but I use him a lot more like a typical fullback in very short yardage situations where I need maybe 1-2 yards, or if I'm, you know, 4th and goal on the 1 and I really need to score, I'll run this guy up the gut. You can pass to him, but I don't trust his hands quite as much as some of the other guys, so you're going to want to look at this guy more as a runner. Number 2 on this year's list is one of my favorite fullbacks to play with in all of Madden, John Connor from the New York Knicks. This guy is very good and very well balanced throughout all of his stats. His speed is a 72, his acceleration is an 81, and agility is a 68. His strength is a 77, so he's one of the higher strength guys to go along with that speed. He is very, very hard to tackle and very sure-handed. His trucking is a 75, which is very high. Catching is only a 54, so you can throw to him, but I would use that sparingly. You want to run with this guy more than anything. His carrying is a 73, which is the highest on this list. Again, he's a slightly better run blocker than pass blocker. He has a 72 stiff arm, a 66 spin move, and a 61 juke move. So his moves are very good. You can think of him as kind of a slow running back. That's how I like to use this guy. His impact block is a 91. He's one of the better blockers on this game, so if you don't use your fullback to run at all, he's still a good person to have on your team. You can use him as a backup when you absolutely need to run, but even if you don't do that, he's always going to pick up the blocks for you in very tough situations, give your quarterback much more time to get free and get passes for you. Number one is the Arizona Cardinals' Anthony Sherman, and this guy can flat-out play. He is the fastest guy on this list with an 80 speed, 75 acceleration, and 72 agility. His strength is 78, which puts him up there in the upper side of the strength category as well. Trucking is just a 58, so he doesn't really run over people a lot. He's got great hands, 73, that's the highest on this list. His carry is 67, which is still good. Stiff arm is a 74, spin is a 65, and his juke moves a 62, so he has all the moves. He can break tackles. He's pretty elusive for this type of a player. He's one of the taller guys as well, so you can actually hit him with some passes that other guys can't necessarily always catch. His impact block is an 81, which is very high. Like I said, the guy can do it all. He can block for you. He can get short yardage for you. He can break out on the flats or in a short cross route across the center and end up picking up some pretty decent yardage for you as a receiver as well. He's quick enough that you can motion him out at the beginning of a play, and if you get him on the right linebacker or something like that, he has some breakaway speed from slower players. So test him out and see what you think. All right, that was my top five under-the-radar fullbacks for Madden 13. I hope you enjoyed. If you think that I left someone off or if you think that the order should have been rearranged, I'd love to hear that in the comment section. I always love reading those. Next week, we're going to start defense. I believe I'm going to go with linebackers to start. That's what most people asked for, so get ready for that. I'd love to see some more likes than usual on this video to kind of get us pumped up for defense. I'm not going to beg you guys for it, though. Thanks for watching, guys. Let me know if there's anything I can do to change this series up and make it better or whatever you guys want to see. Just let me know. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will catch you next time.